welcome to the Lime Old Lime Players' second performance of Once Upon a Mattress. In case of fire or other emergency, there are two exits located on both the mezzanine and lower level. If you are for some reason confused, take a glance to your left, or if you're feeling daring, your right, and you will see some bright glowing red exit signs. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
stormy night to the castle door. Him alas the prince had been waiting for. I'm a princess lost, quoth she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said, perhaps Bubble needs some proof. I'll prepare a test and see. I will test her thus, the old queen said. I'll place 20 downy mattresses upon her bed, and beneath those 20 mattresses I'll place one tiny key. And if that key disturbs her slumber, then the true princess is she. Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen, my dear, if you felt that fear, then we've proof enough of your royalty, that the wedding music lay. And the people shouted quietly, for a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air, but a genuine princess is exceedingly accurate. And I happen to know the real story of the Princess and the Pea for the very good reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom, overruled by a talkative queen and a mute king. And the princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test. In fact, she was one of 13 girls. Girls who came to the castle hoping to wed the prince, but who, for some reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived at court, they were testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.
Are you ready for the next question?
I guess so.
The next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well, name three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name three kings.
May I take the third king first? Well then, three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to find out if she's a true princess.
King John, King Arthur, and...
Well, does it matter if she's a true princess?
Of course. If she's a true princess, we can all get married.
King Ethelred.
That is absolutely... correct.
She's smart, Mama, but she's the best one yet. Can I marry her now? Can I?
Oh, no, sweetheart. There's still one more question.
This test isn't going to be fair.
The law that isn't fair.
The law?
The marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed till dauntless to the altar's led.
Dauntless?
Oh, the prince. Until he gets married, none of us can.
You have now reached the seventh plateau, and here is your final question. It is divided into four parts and concerns a famous man, often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. One, what was his name? Two, what beast did he slay? 3, how many rows of teeth did the beast have? And what kind? And 4, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, of the best friend, of the blacksmith who forged the sword that killed the beast?
1, St. George. 2, the dragon. 3, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. And 4, would you repeat the last part of the question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, of the best friend, of the blacksmith who forged the sword that killed the beast?
The middle name?
The middle name.
The daughter-in-law?
Enough. You have 30 seconds.
Oh, please pass. Please, please pass.
Do you speak, my lady?
Oh, no, I...
20 seconds! Oh!
Oh, I wish her luck. She's a pretty little thing.
10 seconds. Oh. I'm terribly sorry.
Oh,
your time is up.
Oh, too bad, my dear, too bad. Do show a certain aptitude, but as for the true brilliance of royalty, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. However, to show that there are no hard feelings, here's a nice consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, and get out.
Dauntless, stop pouting. Don't dilly-dally, Dauntless. It's almost time for your cocoa.
Princess, get the bird.
It's just absurd. I never heard a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack. I lack, alas, alas, alack.
What is it?
Excuse me, Cardamon, but I must take the minstrel to go sign in with the castle steward.
This way, please.
Oh, I'm on my way to Normandy. I shouldn't be staying long anyways.
For your father's sake, I put up with a good deal for you. Don't address me as Cardamon in court. Just because your father and I were in show business together. Don't presume.
Oh, Sir Harry.
My darling, you missed the test.
Sweet Larkin, my new responsibilities as chivalry knight of the Herald keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck. But don't despair. If a true princess is not found in the next few months, then I will go and find one myself. Or I will deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love?
Do you remember the royal joust in Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Yes, of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you, that you might someday become a chamberlain or even prime minister.
Well, I don't know about prime minister.
Do you remember the picnic we had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes, of course.
And you and I wandered up the hills away from the others to watch the sun go down?
Yes, of course.
And there was a lark singing in the trees, and you said you'd remember that moment forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name.
Yes, Larkin, yes.
And then we watched the sun go down?
Yes.
Well? I'm going to have a baby. So you see, a princess for Dauntless must be found, or soon I will have to go away somewhere. Oh, Harry, I'm so worried. This could ruin you, and you'd never be prime minister or anything. Just say the word, Harry, and I'll go now. I'll go far away. Well, they'll never find me. Just say the word.
No. We'll stay here. Why should we suffer all of our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry.
We're none of us perfect. Everything's going to be all right.
Thank you.
It won't be long, because it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore, I shan't belong to anyone but you.
Is the way I had it planned.
sake, don't squint. I told you not to look at the sun.
Yes, Mama.
That's better.
Sex arrests! I've told you once, I've told you 100 times, I will not have you running around and playing these foolish games in the halls. It just isn't dignified. We are the rulers of the kingdom, and if we don't set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who will. I mean, what is the point of being a ruler if one isn't going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama.
Now what?
Mama, when am I going to get my princess?
I don't want to discuss that right now. It's almost time for your cocoa.
But Mama, sometimes I get the funniest feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married? Don't want you to get married? Don't you trust me?
Of course, Mama.
Well, enough when you say such a thing. Don't want you to get married? How many times have I said to you I want you to get married? Only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, sexiness, I want that boy to get married. It just isn't normal for a boy who stays to stay single, and after all, he is the prince, I said. He's next in line to the throne. And on one hand, we're not the oldest people in the kingdom, but on the other hand, we're not going to live forever. And I know that I feel much easier, much more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married and settled in his head, and that is absolutely verbatim. Exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But that's my cross of pain, and I don't want you to worry your little head one tiny bit on the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. If he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, I just have to put up with it, and I will not allow it to affect my child's attitudes towards him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father, and I want you to respect him. Of course, there is only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your happiness and your health and your future, and that's what I'm talking about right now, your future. I want to make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. I mean, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want you to make the same mistakes as I did and wind up miserable the way I did. You must marry someone good enough and fine enough and sweet enough for my nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And she has to be a real princess. That is one thing I absolutely insist upon. She has to be a real, true, genuine princess, just as I was. Isn't that what you want? Someone like me? Oh, God, if only I could. Oh, just remember this. You must trust me. Your Majesty.
Your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Don't interrupt.
Well, Sir Harry has something he wishes to speak to you about, madam.
Well?
Madam, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, a princess of the royal blood. One that will not only suit your majesty, but also the Prince Solace.
No.
Mama!
No, no, no. We've been through all the eligible girls in all the neighboring kingdoms. There are none left. We must simply have to wait until the younger sisters grow older, and that'll take years.
But madam, I plan to go north, over the mountains.
Over the mountains?
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands?
And into the marshland where the beautiful swamp lily grows.
Into the marshland. Are you out of your mind?
Mama, let him go! Let him go!
There's like nothing there but frogs and tadpoles and things.
Mama!
Do you know what the weather there is like?
Mama!
How damp and foggy?
Mama!
Quiet! And human and oppressive?
Mama, please, let Sir Harry try!
For me? All right. It's your sinus.
Hooray!
Ugh, come along, Dauntless. You've missed your cocoa.
Good luck, Sir Harry. Good luck!
Sweet Larkin. Don't be afraid. I'll bring back a princess who's not only a true princess, but one who'll be able to pass a princess.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We'll be waiting for you.
We?
You know. Oh, take this.
Thanks to my heart.
I will see your smile on the face of my son. is gone to see his girl waiting for me.
Thank you.
Secretive.
Well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I'd better get out of these wet clothes.
May I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
Hey, you're pretty nice.
You're nicer.
And you're good looking, too.
You're better looking, and nicer, too.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
Oh, Your Majesty, Sir Harry is back. And he's brought us a sweet princess. Have you seen her? Neither have I, but I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom, and I'm to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything. My father expected me to follow in his footsteps, but then I landed this jester job, and what's wrong? You're worried. About what? Who? A lady. Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. Bird. Some kind of bird.